G'day guys, back again. Hope you're all doing well. Picked up this little kit last week. I've been looking for this kit for quite some time. Well, not with the figures, but just the RSO. I've actually got the one which I'll put up on screen, which is the same kit from the Tamiya brand in the box. That one's a bit harder to find, so I wanted to pick up another one. So I found this little fella last week, and at the time I didn't know that it came with all these figures. I just thought that was on the box art. But it does come with, as you can see there, 7 figures. Don't be fooled, it's not a new kit. This kit dates back to, I think, around 1976. So it's a very old kit, and it's nothing flash now. But if you like some of the older kits, even like some of the old Tamiya kits, they're still fun to build. You just got to watch out for a couple of things, mainly the alignment of parts. And any warping, and obviously sink marks. Some of these old kits have quite a lot of sink marks in them. And obviously the rubber band plastic type tracks, they're pretty woeful these days when you compare them to new tracks. Just a couple of things about the kit. Now, first off, you don't buy these types of kits for the figures. The figures inside this box is absolutely pretty appalling. But for the price, I'm not buying it for the figures. If I want a decent figure, I'll go out and buy an Alpine Miniatures figure or Evolution Miniatures figures. For me, they're the two best brands of figures you can buy pretty much in 1/35 scale in resin. When you're looking at German figures, they hands down are the best two companies in my opinion. And if you really complain about the figures, well, you're in the wrong market. You shouldn't be buying these sorts of kits for the figures. It's a bit like the old Tamiya kits. The figures are appalling to today's standards, but again, like I said, if you want a decent figure, you're gonna have to pay a good probably $10-$15, maybe $20 per figure if you want something decent. You're not going to get 7 figures in a box like this and expect to get good figures. It's just not going to happen. Although in saying that, I will say some of the newer figures from Tamiya are certainly a hell of a lot better than what they used to be in their new kits. They're definitely usable, and if you want, you can obviously change the heads over. But again, I'll say even the new Tamiya figures in their kits don't compare to anything from an Alpine Miniatures resin figure or an Evolution Miniatures figure. But then again, like I said, for those sort of figures, you're going to be paying $20 per figure. Now, what I would have preferred, rather than getting all these figures and the table and the crate and all that, which for me, I think is probably a bit of a waste, given that you can probably get some better accessories from MiniArt. Or other companies like that. What I would have preferred is if Italeri actually gave you what they did a long time ago, was their Nurbelwerfer. Hope I pronounced that properly. Also in 1/35 scale, which I'll put a picture up of. Now the reason why I would have preferred that than these figures is A, I'm not going to be using these figures, and B, it's very hard to find a Nurbelwerfer without paying in 1/35 scale without paying quite a lot of money for it. Even the old Italeri one now is quite expensive to pick up and pretty much not worth the money people are asking for on eBay. And all the other option is you've got the, I think it's the Great Wall Hobby version in 1/35 scale, and it might be a Line Raw, maybe the same company. That kit itself is getting up to close to the price of this actual kit. So it's almost, by the time you add that to it, you're basically buying two kits. And obviously the Great Wall one is also a more complicated build than the very, very old Italeri kit. If you're going to do an old RSO, I'd probably prefer you to actually add the old Nurbelwerfer kit with that, which they did do in the past as well. And I would have much preferred that than these figures. I kind of think they missed the boat on that, given that it's so hard to get a Nurbelwerfer in 1/35 scale now. I think they would have probably sold more of these kits if they combined those two in the one box. I'll tell you one thing that does bug me about this box and the side of the box, and I really do see it as pretty much false advertising. I can't stand on the front of the box, they give you the canvas cover for the back, and here you can see it as well. And obviously on the front here as well. And I just don't understand these days how modeling companies can get away with putting it on the box art here. I think it's just very deceiving, and I just don't think it's something that should be done. In my opinion, it's all very well to say the canvas cover is not included, But you know what? If it's not included, don't put it on the box art and don't put it on the side of the box art, because as far as I'm concerned, if you pick up a kit, you may not read that little bit down there when you're buying it in the shop. And I just think it's very deceiving. I've noticed a couple of trumpeter kits have done that as well with some of their modern US Army trucks and stuff like that. They've got the canvas on the box art, but they actually don't include it in the kit. And I just think it's a pretty deceiving thing to be doing, so I'd prefer it if they didn't do it. But that's my little spit. Now, obviously, you can go out and buy the new Dragon kit of the RSO, and I don't know what's really happened with Dragon, especially in Australia here, that some of the kits here you used to be able to pick up very cheaply, maybe around $40 when the price was good. You could pick up in a hobby store, you could pick up a Dragon kit, even some of the Tiger tanks back then with all the steel barrel and all the photo etching back then, you could pick up for about $40. And now, for some reason, I don't know what's going on with Dragon, but some of their kits now in the hobby stores are up around the $100 mark Australian. So almost double to 2.5 times the price that they used to be. So to me, even though some of the Dragon kits, they're great kits, the price is just a bit of a turnoff for me. I actually have started building the RSO from Dragon, and I've actually stopped halfway through building the chassis, just because I found the chassis a little bit annoying, just a bit frustrating. And I think my problem is I'm used to building the Tamiya kits, and even some of the modern Tamiya kits, and they're just a joy to build, the Tamiya kits. You sort of just can sit down, plod along, you don't really get very frustrated. The parts always have a very good joining or connection point to the next part. And some of the Dragon kits, especially the instructions, when I look at the instructions, I kind of just get pretty frustrated straight up. If you open up a Dragon instruction sheet compared to a Tamiya instruction sheet, you'll totally understand what I'm saying. Yes, they do have a lot more parts in the Dragon kits, and obviously the Dragon kit's a lot newer than this by about 30 years or 40 years, but it's just that I just find a lot of the Dragon kits not that enjoyable to build. Some of the newer kits now, the smart kits, are a bit more enjoyable. But it's just that some of the connection points with the Dragon kits, they just don't line up as easily as with the Tamiya kit. Tamiya kit, you don't really even need to find exactly where the part's going to go. It almost just clips in with the Dragon. It's sort of like looking at the instructions, looking back at the part and trying to find out where it's going to go. So what I'd actually prefer if actually Tamiya could actually bring out a new version of this kit, updated, and I think I'd be much, much more happier with that than building the Dragon kit. I'm just putting this up here because I actually didn't know this was available until I just came across it on eBay one day, and I was actually looking for something else for my Tamiya kit, so I just thought I'd list a couple of upgrade parts for this kit. If you're actually thinking about picking this up and you're wanting to do a couple of parts for it, you can get about 3 different sorts of tracks for this kit at the moment, and I'll put them up on the screen. You can grab the Frul tracks. I don't mind those. I get a bit tired of clipping all the wires off all the time. The other set you can pick up is the Master Club set, which I actually have. And I've actually bought that for my Panzer III as well, the Master Club set. But I also have the Frul set as well. And I can tell you, after doing the Frul set and clipping off all the wires and putting them in, and then doing the Master Club set, I much prefer doing the Master Club set of tracks. And I actually think they just look better. Just as good, if not better, than the Frul tracks. And they certainly look a lot more detailed, and you don't have that silly piece of wire hanging out one side of the tracks. And the other set of tracks, which I picked up the other day, again I'll put up on screen, is the model custom tracks, and they also come with new sprockets to fit on this vehicle. And the next thing you can pick up is some better wheels for it as well, which I found on a Terry Ashley's site on Perth Military Modelling. And you can pick up some new wheels which look a lot better than these ones in this kit, and also in the Dragon kit, if you look at Terry Ashley's review on that site. And they are from, I'm not sure how you pronounce it, but it's 1120 Productions. And I'm not sure if you have a look on his site, you'll see the review on them compared to the Dragon wheels, and they do look a lot better. So if you wanted to spend a bit more money on this kit, you can also pick those up as well. One of the other things, if you actually do want a canvas cover, And it's very hard to find now. You've got to actually track down and have a good look around to find it. I do believe it was from maybe an off company or something from Warriors called Trax, which is T-R-A-K-Z. As far as I know, they did look like, anyway, quite a nice resin top that fits on this vehicle. There is another resin top around, but that's you need to be careful when you're looking for them, because most of the newer ones now actually fit the Dragon kit. So you just need to be careful of which one you're picking up. You might be a bit disappointed if it doesn't fit. If you're looking at spending a bit more time on it, which is getting closer to a Dragon kit, in the way of hours spent on it, Voyager also did a PE upgrade set for this vehicle as well. And also I think Royal Models has also done a set for this as well, where they give you a couple of extra resin seats and PE for the grills and some of the latches and stuff like that as well. Now, just to top that off, very old figures now and hard to track down, is that you can pick up the sets, I believe, from Warriors that actually were designed for this vehicle. It might have been a summer and a winter set. And obviously you could kit bash some other figures to fit in there as well, putting some more modern heads on top of them. There's also a couple of different sort of sets of decals, aftermarket decals, you can buy for this as well. I think one of them might have been from Bison, so you could pick one up with some RSO decals on it. Anyway, guys, this was really just a bit of a heads up for people that don't know if this kit is, that this kit's back out again. If you're not looking to buy the Dragon kit and you're just wanting a simple weekend build, obviously if you're not adding all the aftermarket details. If you're after probably the best looking kit out there at the moment, I'd go and buy the Dragon kit. But if you're looking for a very simple build, well, you could just build this straight out of the box, or like I said, you could add a lot of the aftermarket stuff, which would then actually take you above the price of the Dragon kit. But it just really depends on what you prefer building. Thanks a lot for watching. I'll catch you later.